What's going on, guys? SP Architects here, and in today's tutorial we are going to learn how to make roof construction in ARCHICAD. Generally, when we make a roof, we just use that roof as we did the roof construction tool, but when in the sections, therefore we cannot see the roof construction. So when we make a roof, after designing and placed top of the building, we need to make roof construction elements for that, because by doing so, we are going to see our roof construction element in the section. Alright, but before we get started, I would just like to ask you to like this tutorial, because it's going to help this channel growing up, and in the future, I'm going to make similar tutorials like this. Okay, so let's get started. I start with making some roof designs. I just go to roof tool, and in the construction method, I select this one, and go to plan view. I start with an edge like this, and make a corner here, and complete the roof. As you can see, ARCHICAD has automatically created roof height and the pitch. I select the roof, and here we have roof pitch dimension. I can change this one, for example, 30 degrees, or if I select this arrow, we can see two options here. First one is the degree and second one is the percent. I'm just go with the percent. And for the volume, I'm just going to change this 30%. And for the elevation, I change this one with 0 and hit enter. If I go to this elevation, it's on the ground floor. If I select the roof, go to 0 ground floor, and I select this story 1. Now it was stitched on the story 1 level. Let's go to floor plan. By the way, I want to change the unit settings, project preferences, perfect units, millimeter, centimeter, okay. And also we can see this offset options. It determines the space between this line and this blue line. We can also change this design by clicking this edge. We can offset. And as you can see, this volume was changed. Also, you can fix it from here. Or you can click this corner and you can change the horizontal reach like this. Control plus Z. And also, I can change this horizontal reach offset. I go to roof tool again, and this time I select this one like this, or you can use this one like this. But the difference between this, we have a slope here, and with this roof construction we don't have a slope here. And with this tool we can make our roof designs like this. But the difference is, as you can see here, if I change this one, first I have made the angle of the roof, and second I made the direction of the roof. Okay, we can just get rid of that. And this, alright, if you want to take a section of these roofs, we just go to section 2 right here, and I'm going to make a section of this roof. I will look to this direction. After that, I select the section and open it current view settings. As you can see, this was the roof we just cut, and these are the roofs behind of this roof. But if we just zoom in this roof, we can see additional levels inside, and these levels is determined by this structure type. We can just go with this simple structure with the roof, because it is the timber roof construction. And if we just go with this composite style, and if you change the style, for example this with this roof tiles, you will see this additional levels inside of this roof. By the way, if you don't want to see these roofs behind this, you just go to floor level, and when you select this section, you go to this second options right here, select this one, and now you can see this section range, and it goes to here. If you click this edge, you can determine the range of the section, for example to here or to here. Let's go to section again, and now we can see our section clearly. By the way, this is the roof level, this 0 point, this is the elevation of the story one, and this is the reference line of the our roof construction, and this space tells you the position of the eave hang right here, and you can change this from here. But the problem is, as the title of this video tutorial, we can only see these levels of the roof with fillings, and of course you can use this roof with this one like this, but if you want to see the construction of the roof, if we just make it simple, you must see something like this. To carry this roof with the construction, this can be a problem, because in your projects you must use this roof construction elements, and you have to see them in the your sections, and also it's good to see them in the 3D views. But as you can see, we don't have any roof construction. Okay, in order to achieve that, you just select the roof and you go to design and roof extras, roof maker and roof wizard. But the problem is, we cannot use the roof wizard in the 3D view. So in order to do that, we have to go to floor level and select our roof, go to design, roof extras, roof maker and the roof wizard. This is the famous magical roof settings. It's going to make your life easier, because you will only change these settings in harmony with your project. For example, we have rafters here. We can change their width settings, height settings, and the eave angle, vertical, rectangular, perpendicular. I'm gonna select this vertical. And also we can open up this soffit, and we can change the visibility with the 2D view settings, axis line type. The distance between normal rafters can be changed here, minimal distance and so on. And the beams also here, purlins, trimmers, ridges. For the surface that is gonna be used, you can use this box and change the roof surface. And we have the roof construction layer here. Okay, let's click OK. Let's check it out in the 3D view. There we go. We have the roof construction. These are the soffits, rafters and trimmers, we can see. Just create it. And also, as you can see here, they are intersected in the 3D view. Our duty here, we have to select this roof and change its elevation with the height of the rafter. And I prefer doing that in the section view. Suspend groups on. Sorry, off. And I move this up like this. This is the construction, and this is the surface of the roof, for example, insulation, rock wool, or roof tiles. Alright, let's try another example from here with this roof. I want to change this slab with a lower slab slope angle. And after that, I select this one, the single type, and change the override surface with a basic roof tiles and go OK. I just go to floor level with F2. I select the roof, go to design, roof extras, roof maker, and roof wizard. And I like these settings. I just go with the OK. And there we go. Let's just raise this up as 8 centimeters. And OK. Now I have a question for you. If you want to make a chimney opening, what will you do? For example, with this one. If you go to floor level, select your roof, suspend grooves on, click the edge of the roof, click this minus, make a rectangle, a chimney rectangle opening, but nothing changed with the roof construction. Let's go to 3D. This roof construction is still there. In order to fix that, there are several options. For example, you can select this part of the roof construction and play around with the settings, or also let's go to floor level and go to design, roof extras, and we can reshape this roof it manually, or we can reconstruct this roof one by one with this roof tools. Also, it is easier to open this toolbox up. To use this one, we just select our roof, open this command, okay. I'm gonna click this face of the roof and go with the settings and click on the edge of the surface of the roof, and it will make our rafter. These are very detailed settings. You can inspect them with your ArchiCAD, experience them one by one in your roof designs. But I don't like to use this manual roof construction. In order to fix that manually, I will just select the roof construction and delete it and make a new roof construction. Roof wizard. And OK. We cannot see the roof construction because it's filling with the white color. To make that white color transparency, you just go to this floor plan and section, and we have this cover fill background band. Open that up and click this empty circle, and maybe there could be another problem with the elevation. Let's go to 3D view. Okay, we have the settings. Let's go to story 1. Okay, it is visible at the story 1. Let's go to this section. Drag to here. By the way, as you can see here, the opening here was automatically created. You can see these extra rafters created here and created here, and also this additional rafters here. Go to section, select the roof, drag to here, and you can change the thickness or construction types. Maybe you can select the roof and right click, edit, select profile. As you can see here, you can see these isolations, membrane, rainproof, tiling, timber, plaster. With this example, we no need this timber structure. I just click that timber and remove skin. Also, I'm going to get rid of that plaster gypsum, remove skin, line pens are okay, thickness 5 cm airspace, we don't need this airspace, remove skin, membrane, airspace, tile roof, maybe we can add some skin here, and with this skin we can, where is that, okay here. I'm gonna make that plywood, and for the thickness, let's go with 1 cm. Onto that plywood, there is membrane with 0 cm, okay. And of course you can add your roof detail levels as you want. I just go with this and okay. I think that's all it for this tutorial. Please like and share this tutorial. If you have any question or suggestion, please comment down below. See you at the next one.